Red Dead Online Summer Update has officially got a release date. Next week on the 13th of July, the Red Dead Online, which is now called Blood Money Update, is releasing. We've already looked at the trailer and have thrown out some speculation with what else could possibly be coming. But today, we're getting the last little bit of prep done so that we can hit the ground running when the new Blood Money Update is released. Before I do get into the video, if you do want to see the latest tips and tricks within Red Dead Online, then make sure you hit that subscribe button and that notification bell. That way you'll always be up to date whenever I push a new video. If you do want to see something a bit more on the entertaining side, then make sure you go into the description down below and click that link to the second YouTube channel. I'm currently streaming every Monday, Wednesday and Friday, and it's more about playing a variety of different games and just having fun with what's out there. So a link to that can be found in the description down below. Getting back into the video. Here on this channel, I show you the best tips and tricks in Red Dead, and there's never been a more important time for these types of tutorials than right now, just before a new update releases. I'll be going through some of the things that I'm currently doing to make sure that as soon as the new content is released, I can actually just jump straight into it. The first thing is by completing all previous content. The advertisement for this upcoming Red Dead Online Summer Update is not like what we've had in recent years. Normally, Rockstar tells us what type of content to expect, and they tend to wrap all of this content up as a new role, and they make this clear very early. But this time around, they've said nothing about roles coming to the game, which has led many players to believe that this new type of content isn't going to be wrapped up in a role. It's most likely to be different types of missions or something completely new entirely. But whatever is included, it's likely that you will need to finish or at least participate in some of the previous content. Rockstar have always talked about progression. They want players to start the game, break from prison, live out in the wilderness, and eventually build your character up. So it makes sense that no matter what content is included with this summer update, it will require you to finish some of the previous content that is already within the game. And we have actually been in this situation before. Moonshiner requires you to do at least one trade delivery or reach rank 5 within the trader before getting the Moonshiner. And the prestigious Bounty Hunter requires you to get the Bounty Hunter license. Now we don't know exactly what types of content needs to be done first, but this is just a good idea to complete what's actually there. This is completing the main missions, unlocking all the different roles, and complete the Moonshine missions. I'm also going to make a little prediction here, but I do believe that you must go and complete the Dishonorable missions within the main missions and also go through the Moonshiner. With the bear in mind that there is a mission called Banks Don't Rob Themselves, which does take place in Saint Denis. And after going through the Red Dead Redemption 2 story many times, there's nothing that actually happens within Saint Denis that Angelo Bronte doesn't know about. So it's fair to say that your character, as well as Samson Finch, has a bit of a reputation within Saint Denis. It's also the exact same with the Moonshiner, as a lot of those missions involve you going round Lemoyne. If you are someone that's taken the Bayou location for your Moonshine check, you would have also had many deliveries to many different saloons within Saint Denis as well. Now this of course is speculation and technically has no links to the video itself, but it is fun to talk about, and it's also kind of interesting to think within the Red Dead world that the Brontes crime syndicate, Guido Martelli and Angelo Bronte himself know everything that you're doing. The next thing to do is to take advantage of anything that's currently within the game that seems overpowered. This could be the different types of collector sets, legendary animal missions for animal parts, or daily challenges. Last year, we had two major updates, being the Naturalist and Bounty Hunter Enhancement, both of which brought huge nerfs to the game, which capped how much money and how much gold you can make. The Naturalist changed the way that certain collector sets worked. It used to be that you can go to any of these collector locations and you'll be able to find the collectible. But since this update, it's made certain collector sets random, so that you can go to any of these locations, you can still pick up the collectible, but it's random of which collectible you get, making it a lot harder for you to actually finish that collector set within just one day. It now will take multiple days for you to finish the coin, jewelry, arrowheads, and the new edition of fossil sets. The Bounty Hunter enhancement changed daily challenges by giving you half the payout of what you were originally getting, and it also stopped us from having daily challenge streaks beyond 28 days. If you was a player that was grinding every single daily challenge and you carried on doing this beyond 28 days, you've actually had more than a 60% reduction in how much gold that you can currently make. Now, the reason that I bring all of this up is to show you the lengths in which Rockstar will go to just to nerf something. And chances are, content that's already within the game will change with this next update. This is just game iteration. Some things could be buffed, whereas other things could be nerfed. The problem is that we don't know what Rockstar are planning to do. So the best thing to do is to take advantage of everything that seems overpowered as of right now. This is still the collector sets, the legendary animal missions from Harriet, and the daily challenges. All of this content can make you rich within game in a relatively fast time. And just in case Rockstar are planning to nerf any of these pieces of content, you might as well take advantage of them now. The next thing to do is stack up on as much gold, money, and XP as you possibly can. Now, I have already done videos talking about this previously, showing you the best legit ways to grind money and gold. So if you do want to see those videos, there'll be links to both of them in the description down below, as well as there'll be a card top right on your screen right now, which you can click and it'll take you directly to that video. But as a quick overview, I always recommend having 100 gold. This just puts you in a very comfortable position so that you can buy new content, as well as taking into consideration that it gets more and more expensive each time, and also still leave some gold left over for outlaw passes and any other cosmetic items that you want. And this gold is essential. If you don't have the gold, you can't buy into new content. I also recommend having around $10,000. Now, with cash, you can't actually use it to buy into new content because Rockstar monetized this by making you pay gold. But cash is used to buy essential items once you've got past that initial payment. This can make your experience a lot better when going through whatever content is added. And $10,000 should be way more than enough for you to be able to buy into all of these essential items. And the last thing that I recommend is getting to level 100. It's not as important as getting gold and money, but this is still something that Rockstar could link into. So far, we haven't had any content that's been added in the past couple of updates that requires you to have a certain level for you to get access to the roles. But that's because the roles that have been added have their own ranking system. The only content that's been locked behind your character rank is weapons, horses, and pamphlets. But if this new content isn't something that's wrapped up in a role, which we have spoken about in this video, then it's got a whole different type of progression. A progression which could potentially be linked into your character rank, just like certain things are linked into your character rank within GTA Online. This is just one of those things of making sure that it's ticked off, just in case it does happen, even though it is unlikely to happen. And the last thing to talk about is stacking up on as many different items as possible. This is your collector sets, legendary animal pelts and carcasses, and herbs. Collector sets used to be something that I recommended players getting every single time, because as soon as new content was added, it will include an outlaw pass. An outlaw pass that could be ranked up very quickly by selling collector sets. Now, over the last year, I've actually been telling people to make your own decision on this, because some people don't want to finish content quickly. And the benefit that I have when going through this is that I can post a video of it. But with this in mind, I still recommend getting collector sets, because at some point there will be a weekly bonus within the future that increases the price of collector sets. This is when you can make a lot of money from this role. It's also worth saying that there's a good chance that content will be released in this upcoming update that requires collectibles. And this wouldn't be the first time of this happening, and it's most likely not going to be the last. With the Naturalist update, if you went to Gus McMillan's shop as the trapper, there will be certain items that require different collectibles for you to be able to craft them. If you don't have the collectible, you can't craft them, and it's simple as that. If you manage to get at least one of every collectible now, it does put you in a good position that if those collectibles are required for any type of cosmetic items or any type of new gameplay items, then you can buy into them straight away because you have all the materials. Legendary animal parts and also herbs have the exact same benefit. If anything is added as part of this next update which requires herbs or legendary animal pelts or even animal parts, you should have it stored in your satchel ready for you to buy into it straight away so that you don't have to worry about going back into some of the previous content just so you can play the new content. But legendary animals and herbs also have an added bonus because they can be used to help benefit the trader and moonshiner. And if you manage to stack up on everything now, you can actually go into this next update and carry on these roles without having to put any time into them whatsoever. I've managed to stack my hunting wagon and will continue stacking my hunting wagon with as many legendary animal pelts as I possibly can. That way, when this new update does arrive, I'll just chuck as many legendary animal pelts and turn them into materials and I never have to worry about hunting another legendary animal again for at least a couple weeks. It's also the exact same with the moonshiner, as I can continuously add different types of flavor into my moonshine. All I need to do is go back over to the moonshine shack, buy moonshine mash, add flavoring, and then I'm done. That way I can still play through all the new content, have fun with it, but I do not lose out on the cash that the trader and moonshiner will be giving me. This is just a very efficient way of playing, and it's something that I've been doing with every update since the summer update in 2019. If you do have any questions about anything that I've talked about in this video, of why I'm stacking up on them, or why I'm doing what I'm doing, then feel free to leave them in the comment section down below. But anyway guys, I hope you guys did enjoy. If you did enjoy, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. But for now, I'm going. So see ya.